In Chelik Yudches, look at the Sichas, second Sicha for the Parsha. This is part of the project, look at the Sichas, one of the two Sichas that everybody's learning this week. Chazal Zong, Chazal tell us, Loma Nismacho Parsha's Nozir, the Parsha Saita. Why in the Torah is the Parsha's Nozir written next to the Parsha of Saita? First, the Torah tells us the laws of a Saita. We all know what the laws of a Saita is. If the husband warned his wife not to go into hiding with a certain man and she didn't listen. So then there's a whole procedure. You have to take her to Beis Hamikdash and she drinks water and you write the Megillah and you raise the Megillah into the water, etc. And she drinks it. And if she's innocent, she'll not only have a bracha, but if she's guilty, then she's going to die a certain way, the Torah says. And after that, the Torah goes into the dinim of a Nozir. Nozir is somebody who makes a neder that he's not going to drink wine, not going to be tamal mesim, etc. So Chazal tell us, Brochas, why did the Torah write the Parsha of Nozir next to the Parsha of Saita? Leimanach to tell you, Shekola Reya Saita Bikilkulo. If someone sees a Saita when she is in her kilkul, in her bad situation, Yazer Atzminayayin, he should separate himself from wine, which means that we suspect this woman in as doing adultery, and a lot of these things happen through drinking wine. So if you see the kilkul of the Saita, then you should take upon yourself to become a nozir and not drink wine. For the same reason, the inyan of Saita and the inyan of nozir are close to each other in Teira Shabbat Peh, which means Mesichta Saita kum gleich noch Mesichta Nozir. In Mishnais and the Gemara, Mesichta Saita comes right after Mesichta Nozir. Again, here we see that they're close to each other. And it's for the same reason. The Gemara zokt in only Mesichta Saita, like the Gemara says in the beginning of Saita, the Gemara says Tana min Nozir Salik. The Tana who's writing the Mishnais of Saita is coming right after Nozir. My Tana de Katana Saita. Why is he? What did he say before that? Right after that, he's telling us about the Saita, and the answer is Kederebbe, like Rebbe said, Loma Nismacho Parshas Nozir la Parshas Saita. Why is the Parsha of Nozir in the Torah close to Parsha of Saita? For the same thing, Shekolareya Saita Bikulkulu. Yazir, anybody who sees a Saita in her problem, in her kilkul, should separate himself from wine. So we see with the same logic that we're using, why in the Torah, Nozir and Saita are close to each other. The same thing is also in the Mishnayis, why the Mishnayis and Saita are close to each other, that Saita comes after Nozir. The Rambam Abishraib, the Rambam, in his introduction to Pirush HaMishnayis, he writes, as Mesichta Saita kum gleich noch Mesichta Gitten. He says the order is different. Saita comes after Gitten. When Nozir kommt vor Gitten, and Nozir is before Gitten. And the reason, what's the connection, he says, between Saita and Gitten? Gitten is divorce. Shenyona de Mesichta Saita minyan hagerishin. Because the union of Mesichta Saita has to do with divorce. Shal Saita keshedizane, if the Saita, this woman who is a Saita, actually was mezane, which means she was behaving immorally, she committed adultery, you have to force him, the man and the woman, to get divorced. So we see the connection between Saita and divorce. That's why Saita is right after Gitten, which talks about divorce. But then the question is, that's not like the Gemara. The Gemara gives a different reason. Rambam can't say different than the Gemara. Also, the Gemara is okinal tone, tanem and nozik salik, my tone, the katana Saita, shkolareya Saita, yoziratzmi. We quoted before that the Gemara itself gives a reason why is Saita right next to Nozir, because if you see a Saita, you should separate yourself, make yourself a Nozir, separate from wine. So the Gemara says it. How could the Rambam give a different reason? He says, the Meiri is Masbi. So the Meiri, one of the Rishonim, explains, while Gitten ve Saita inyan ze echadim. Saita and Gitten are one inyan. She sibes agerish and besibes akilkul. What's the reason why a person would divorce his wife? Because she spoiled it. She did what she wasn't allowed to do. So really, Saita and Gitten go together. V'nismecha Gitten v'Saita l'Nozir. So Gitten and Saita are close to Nozir. So really, Saita is next to Gitten. But Gitten itself is, Gitten is next to Saita, and Nozir is right before that, because the union of Saita and Gitten is like one thing. Then the next word is not clear, the Rebbe says, maybe it means l'medrash or l'hadrash, shakil k'labom and tzadayayin geirem Gitten v'Saita. That what it means to say that because you drink wine, that could bring a person to Gitten and Saita. So Gitten and Saita go together, and they're close to Nozir, because of the Nozir, if you see what happens to a Saita, as the Gemara says, which could bring to a get, you should separate yourself from the wine. But Lapel Mamish, the Mesichta Saita, is not after Nozer, but it's after Git. Not like we have in our way, in the print, in the Mishnais, and the way the Gemara seems from the Gemara, not seems, the Gemara says clearly that Saita and Nozer go together, but the Rambam says not, and what the Gemara meant, the Gemara meant Saita and Gitin go as one thing, and that's close to Nozer. That from Bashtein, so the Rebbe says we have to understand. The Baldas and Tereshiv Iksav Kuman, the two parshis from Saita and Nozer, glide with Smichazel and Salazer. Since in Chumash and Tereshiv Iksav, Saita and Nozer come next to each other, actually next to each other. Havazel the Tereshiv Alpeh. So why in the Mishnayis, which is Tereshiv Alpeh, with the Smichas, Mesichta and Nozer, Tzigit and Saita, means at the Mzelden time in Tereshiv Iksav, there the connection between Saita and Nozer is for the same reason as in Chumash, Zaina have sex vision Zay. Why over there should it be with the separation of Mesichta Gitten? According to the Rambam, the idea is that Saita should be next to Nozir, but nevertheless, there is Mesichta Gitten in the middle. So according to the Rambam, Saita comes after Gitten, Gitten comes after Nozir. So Nozir is close to Gitten and Saita, as we said before, that they're like one thing. But Lapela, it's not the same as in Chumash. In Chumash, we see clearly Saita and Nozir mamish next to each other, and in Teirish Abapai, according to the Rambam, in Mishnayis, it's Saita and Nozir, but in the middle you have Gitten. We also have to understand what is svaras vas boras haplukta tisaita kum gleich noch nozir vi rashes mefarish vi pashtas loshma gemore or the noch mesichta gitten kshitus rambam. Besides the question we asked before, why should it be different? What is the logic behind the argument between Rashi? Rashi learns that saita and nozir go next to each other, and that's mashma from the simple words of the gemore. Why is nozir next to saita? So what's the reason for that opinion? And what's the reason for the other opinion, the Rambam's opinion, that gitten is in between? That Saita really is next to Gitten. Zayin Adom Aforshim, the Arma Aforshim brings the Ma'im Chaim, the Pichodesh, explain, but Lena, they learn at the Rambam Gate Lashita Sar Yerushalmi. The reason that Rambam holds that Saita is next to Gitten, that goes according to the Yerushalmi. Adirinyan Akino Yistolu B'Gedish. According to Yerushalmi, the fact that a person warns his wife not to go into hiding with this man, which is the whole basis of a Saita could only become a Saita if the husband warns her and says, do not go into hiding with this man. So he says that this inyan of warning is connected to get. But the far halter has Masichta Saita kum noch Gitten. That's why he says Masichta Saita comes right after Gitten, because Gitten and Saita have a very close connection. That's why in as it comes out from Yerushalmi, and that's why the Rambam learns like that. So he follows the Yerushalmi. What do we see in Yerushalmi? In Yerushalmi state, it says in Yerushalmi, as he plucked it zwischen Rabbi Eliezer, there in Yishalmi brings a machlekes between these two people, Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Yeshua. This, that the husband could warn his wife not to go into hiding and that turns into a seita, is an obligation for the husband to do that? Or it's just that he has permission to do it, he's allowed to do it. So the Yishalmi says that the argument between these two, which one of these is an obligation or just that it's allowed, is totally in the plukta from Bishamay Basilim. That depends on an argument between Bishama and Basila, the Mishnah Said Gitten, and the Mishnah at the end of Gitten. What's the argument there? See, the Das Bishama, the Igar Shodam Asishta, Linke Motzaba Ervo. Bishama holds that a person is not allowed to divorce his wife unless he finds some immoral behavior. Or Basila says, no, even if she spoiled his food, she burned the food, he's allowed to divorce her. So Bishama says, you're not allowed to divorce a wife normally unless there's some Dvar Erve, which is some misbehavior and the court and immoral behavior, and according to Basil, you could. So therefore he says like this, what happens if a husband finds not moral things done by his wife, but there are no witnesses? If there are witnesses, you follow what the witnesses say. If they say she did something, then you punish her, whatever. What happens? He knows she did bad things, but there are no witnesses. So he can't prosecute her, so to speak. He's late by Shammai. So according to Bishama, you have a problem. Bishama, you're not allowed to divorce your wife just like that. So the Garshay Niyochel, you can't divorce her. Shalei Motzabad Ervi, you didn't find any moral thing, because if there's no witnesses, you can't say that you really found something immoral. The Kaimei Niyochel, to keep her, you can. Shemotzabad Ovechurin, Varim Churin, because you found immoral things there, so you can't keep her. So what do you do? He said, Deriber Mechuyev in Kinui. So that makes him obligated to warn her. Kedei Tzimavara, as I make Sigvem Bayir Evas Dover, Adonit. That if he warns her, then she goes into the process of a Saita, and then you find out, you verify whether she's guilty or not. So according to the Bishamai, there's a reason for to say that you must, there's a Mechiyuv to the Mekana her, to warn her. In a case like this, there's a Chiyuv to warn her. because you can't divorce her, you can't keep her. So the only way to do it is to divorce her. But that's only according to Bishamai. Mashenkeli Bezilo, but according to Bezilo, as muter legarash afila, afila ignore dichat afshila, you're allowed to divorce even if she spoiled this food. Is kina blazar shoes to warn her and turn into a seita is only that you're allowed to do it. But it's not an obligation to do. Why? Because there is another choice, another option. To give me a get, he can give her a get. See, according to Bisham, he can't give her a get because he has no proof that she did something immoral. So he can't give her a get. So the only way to do it is there's a mitzvah to warn her. But according to Basil, there's no mitzvah to warn her. If she is in a situation like this, that she did something wrong and we don't have edim, you could divorce her. Don't. If you want to, there's a reshus, there's a permission to be mekana her to warn her. Tosfos bring them, I mean, the Rebbe is not finished yet. Tosfos brings this Yerushalmi. Tosfos and Seitat Avgimel brings this Yerushalmi. Umfrek, Tosfos asks the question. The Fiyai Yerushalmi, according to Yerushalmi, Kiv Natalia Kino Bigadish, and since we said the warning of the woman to make her into a Seitat depends on, it's connected to divorce, Havel Elimis and Seitat Boser Gittin. So Seitat should have come right after Gittin, because a Seitat happens when you know the dinim of get, then you can make a Seitat. So Luchura, why is it that Seitat comes after Nazir? Why does a Seitat come after Gittin? That's Tosfos Kasha, according to the Yerushalmi, that Yerushalmi says that the union of Seita is connected to get. So the Mefarshim and Nasa, this is what the Mefarshim come in and say, at late in Yerushalmi, that the Rambam learns that according to Yerushalmi, it's stuck like that. A Seita kumt nor Gittin. According to Yerushalmi, Seita is after Gittin. Because Seita is very close connected to Gittin, to a get, according to the Yerushalmi. And the Rambam learned for the Yerushalmi, and the Rambam learns like the Yerushalmi. So the question before we ask, why does the Rambam learn that Seita comes after Gittin, not after Nozir, like it says by us? Because the Rambam learned the Yerushalmi, and Yerushalmi comes out as connected to Gittin, and the Yerushalmi, and the Rambam paskins like the Yerushalmi. I mean, the Teretz is shredded, but the Teretz is hard to accept. The Baldas be the Babli is nitayla d'minyan akin b'gerushin. Since in Babli, in our Gemara, which is Babli, we don't find this concept that the union of Seita, which is the kinui, the warning of the Seita, is connected to a get. We don't find it. And not only we don't find it, this is Eich Mucha from them will prove it also. Not only we don't find that he says it. That's true. We don't find anywhere where the Yerushalmi connects it. Next kinui, the warning by a Seita to a get, we don't find it in Babli. But besides that, you could even prove it, he says. So in Babli, brengt sich dieselbe Pluk, that the kinui is chever reshus. In Babli, it does bring an argument whether the fact that the person, the husband warns his wife, is an obligation, a must, or just a permission. And Rabbi Shmuel, who are arguing in Yerushalmi, the two people who argue is Rabbi Leizer and Rabbi Yeshua. In Bavli, the argument is between Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Shmuel. Rabbi Akiva says it's an obligation, or Rabbi Shmuel says it's a reshus, it's not an obligation. Or Rabbi Akiva holds as Memeg Megadas and Anisha Filamot Sacheres Noemen. Rabbi Akiva goes even further than Bezilel. Bezilel says you could even divorce her if she spoiled your food, and Rabbi Akiva says you could divorce her even if you just found another one, a nicer one. So according to Rabbi Akiva, you are allowed to divorce your wife. So according to the Rabbi Akiva, you can't say that Seita is a must, and that's why it's connected, because otherwise you can't give a divorce. According to Rabbi Akiva, you could give a get. Kum tu says, L'shitas ha-Bavli is m'sikta Seita nita hemshich tzum sov gidin. So it comes out, according to the Bavli, the union of Seita is not a continuation to what it says at the end of Gidin that B'shamai holds, that you're not allowed to divorce your wife. See, according to the Yerushalmi, it's a connection, because the Yerushalmi says that the fact that you have to be mekana your wife is because you can't give her a get. Because it goes like Yerush, like because according to Bishamai. But in Bavli doesn't say that, because the one that says that it's an obligation to do it, it happens to be Rabbi Akiva, who doesn't hold that you're not allowed to divorce your wife. So why? So there's no connection. So how do we have to learn according to the Bavli, since there is no connection between Seita and a get? So it doesn't come after Gittin. So according to the Bavli, like it says in simple Gemara, that Seita comes after Nozir. According to Yerushalmi, it is like that. And we're saying that Rambam will hold like Yerushalmi. But since Bavli clearly is not like that, according to the Bavli, it's not connected. The fact that you're are obligated, according to this opinion, you're obligated to warn your wife and make her into a Seita, is not connected to a get. So you can't say the reason of why Seita comes after Gittin. And usually when there's a machlokes between Bavli and Yerushalmi, we pass like the Bavli. So here we have, according to Yerushalmi, very possible that according to the way Yerushalmi learns, Taka Gitin, Saita has to come after Gitin, but not according to the Bavli. So how could we say that the Rambam says that Saita comes after Gitin because it goes according to Yerushalmi? It's against the Bavli. Nochmed, the question is further. Eif the Rambam then to Mishita Sar Yerushalmi. As Chavis Akino is told to be Gedishin, if we're going to accept that the Rambam goes according to the Yerushalmi, that the obligation to warn your wife is connected, is dependent on the concept of a get, he paskin to be Rabbi Akiva as kinu is a chayva. So how could he say, according to like Rabbi Akiva, that to warn your wife is an obligation, was late in Yerushalmi and now was behesed shittas b'shamay? According to Yerushalmi, why is there an obligation to make her into a seita, to warn her? Because there's no choice. According to b'shamay, there is no choice because it's an obligation to... Since you can't divorce her, according to Bishamai, so there's no other choice but to warn her. But according to Yerushalmi, who is of opinion that it's an obligation to warn her? Bishamai. Because if we're connecting the two, that means that the reason you're obligated to warn her is because you cannot divorce her. That means that who is the one that says that you must warn her? Bishamai. Because Bishamai are the ones that hold that you can't give her a divorce, so maybe there's no choice but to warn her. And according to the Rambam, if he follows like the Yerushalmi, then Yerushalmi says that this is according to Bishamai. See, Bavli doesn't say it's according to Bishamai. Bavli doesn't connect the fact that you have an obligation to warn her, to make her into Saita, to the union of a get. So it's nothing to do with Bishamai. But if the Rambam holds like the Yerushalmi, then it has to do with the fact that you have to give her a get because that's what Bishamai holds. The Rambam paskins that it's an obligation to give a get, to give kinui. And that's connected, according to Yerushalmi, with Bishamai. That means that the Rambam paskins like Bishamai. We know we never paskin like Bishamai. So the question is, why does the Rambam learn that Saita comes after Gitin, not after Nazir? And what's the reason for the Machlekes, which way it is? Let's first understand the Rebbe says, Rambam, as we said before, paskins, that it's an obligation to warn her and to make her into a Saita. That's the halacha. The luchura, first glance. The Gemara is medayik b'loshon Mishnah. He's going to prove luchura that it's not so. Because it says in the Mishnah, the seita mekane liishte, the Mishnah starts off, if somebody warns his wife, etc., etc., etc. The Gemara asks on the loshon of the Mishnah. The Mishnah said, if somebody is mekane, which means warns his wife, then this is the din. So it's mashme, if it happened, the eved ein lechatchila lei, means but the eved, if you warned her, there are certain dinim how to follow. Whole procedure. But as mashman lechatchila, you shouldn't warn her. Because so far tani the don, yes, so that the Gemara says that the Mishnah, which says if you warned her, the din is so and so, this tani holds, osur lekan is that you're not allowed to warn her. Which means we have two opinions before we said whether it's a obligation to warn or just you're allowed to warn. Here the Mishnah holds you're not allowed to bechol warn. It's a isur. So now the question is, vibald as late star Mishnah is osur lekan, since the Mishnah, the first Mishnah doesn't have a name. It's called a Stam Mishnah. Stam Mishnah, when there's a halacha in the Mishnah, it just says a halacha. Always the halacha is like a Stam Mishnah. Here the Mishnah says, if you warned her, so and so happens. Which means that the Mishnah, Tana of the Mishnah holds that you're not allowed to warn her. Only if you warned her, you go ahead with the process. So you're not allowed to warn her. So it comes out that according to the Stam Mishnah is also lekanes. You're not allowed to warn. For vos paskin tevi Rabbi Akiva. So why does Rambam paskin like Rabbi Akiva? The fact that Rabbi Akiva holds that you're allowed to, you're obligated to warn us in a braise. So we have a braise where it says that Rabbi Akiva holds that you're obligated to warn her. We have a Stam Mishnah which says you're not allowed to warn her. So how do you pass? Your klal is doch stom ed masnis umachloik is bibraise halacha kistam. If you have a Mishnah that has no name and it has a halacha, but then you have a braise that has a different opinion. The klal is, the rule is, the halacha is like the Mishnah. So in this case, the halacha should be like the Stam Mishnah, that you're not allowed to warn her. So how does the Rambam say that it's a chayva to warn her? The Tosfos Yontif then, the Tosfos Yontif answers the kasha. He says like this, Baal Dasai Rebbe Akiva Sai Rebbe Yishmol, in the Braisa Halt Mazlavi Suruhu. Now, since we said before that in Bavli, whether it's an obligation to warn her or only a reshus, is a machlekes between Rebbe Akiva and Rebbe Yishmol. But the Tosfos Yontif says, but according to both, it's not like the Mishnah. In the Mishnah, it says you're not allowed to warn her. Here we have two opinions, whether you have to or you're allowed to. But it's different than the Mishnah. Hilchach les hilchasik emasnis. In a case like this, we're in the Braisa, we have two opinions against the Mishnah. We don't pass like the Mishnah. Obono the klal alocha kev rakive mechaveira, and we come to the rule that alocha is rakav akive. If Rabbi Akiva argues with another Tana, the alocha is Rabbi Akiva, and we disregard the fact that in the Mishnah, Stam Mishnah is that you're not allowed to, because here we have a Braisa, which is of Tutanoim, which is different than the Mishnah. But the Rebbe says that Teretz is over nor later the day is that Teretz only fits according to these opinions. As alocha kistam mishnah lagaba braisa gate niton and afal, but istam mishnah is at as yochid. See, there's an argument that when we say that alocha is like a stam mishnah, even though there's a braisa says differently, so there's one opinion that says that this halocha kistam mishnah does not apply in a case where the stam mishnah is an opinion of one person. And then it would fit what the Tesis Yontov says. The mishnah is one person. In the braisa, we have two people. Raya Bakiva, Saira Bishmol, both hold that it's not Osir. The argument is whether it's a Chayva or a Rishus, but it's not Osir. And the Mishnah, which is Osir's own opinion. So if we hold that in a case like this, we don't paskin like the Stam Mishnah, then fine, the Tesis Yontov answer is very good. But in this case, we pass, that's why the Rama paskins like, the not like the Stam Mishnah, because the Aloch is not like the Stam Mishnah. Overly the day is as Eichna Zafal is Aloch Kistam Mishnah, but according to the opinions that Aloch Kistam Mishnah, even if we find different opinions in the Braise, we still paskin like the Mishnah. The Kasha comes back. How in the world did Rambam paskin that it's a Chayvo when it's against the Mishnah, where the Mishnah says that it's Oser? How could the Rambam paskin the Chayvo? This is the opinion of Rabbi Akiva, but the Stam Mishnah says Oser, and the Aloch is all like Stam Mishnah. Yashleimer, so the Rebbe comes up with an interesting answer. This is all a nigla, whole pilpul, the whole nigla pilpul. Yashleimer, as well, Darsa Rambam is nitokin drayin dike machleikis binyan akinoi. According to the Rambam, there's no three-way machleikis here. Till now we're saying three-way machleikis. Osur, the Tanna of the Mishnah says Osur. Then there is an opinion says Rishus, an opinion Oder Cheva. So then the Mishnah is a different opinion than the other two. So if you say Cheva, it's different than the Mishnah. So the question is, how could you pass him different than the Mishnah? But he holds no. The Rambam holds that there's no three opinions. But Rabbi Shmuel or Rabbi Akiva, the Braise, Rabbi Shmuel or Rabbi Akiva, that's in the Braise, saying, "Nit mechulik mit Tana from the Mishnah as also lekanes." They're not arguing. The Tana says it's also true. They agree it's also. They're talking about a different situation. And then he's going to prove it also. He says, "Chmucha from them, it's, I can prove it." The Rebbe says from this, but the Gemara brings me the Braise gleich noch me daigs and a kesover tanya than also the kanes. The Gemara did like this. The Mishnah said, "If you were mekana your wife, etc., etc." Comes the Gemara and says, "Medayik, ah, mashman that is oser, because it says if you were mekana, but yevet the lechatchila not." And the Gemara asks, and the Gemara says, "Yes, and the chaname tano holds that it's oser." The Gemara didn't come right away and say, well, this is against the Braise. If the Braise is an argument against the Mishnah says Osir, and the Braise says two opinions, Rishus or Cheva, but definitely arguing Osir, then why didn't the Gemara say it right away? Al derech with the Gemara brank in the Gei the Deus from Rabbi Lozer and Rabbi Yeshua in the Mishnah, Mekanel Apishnaim. The Gemara says a different point. That from the Mishnah we see different than Rabbi Lozer and Rabbi Yeshua. In the Mishnah it says that in order to warn her, you have to have with two witnesses. And the Gemara says right away that that's what the Mishnah says, but it's not what Rabbi Lozer and Rabbi Yeshua say in the Braise. No, in the Mishnah they say Mekanel Shnayim as Masnis like Yaitan. The Gemara says that this Mishnah does not fit to a different opinion, which Rabbi Yeshua Mekanel Al Piyadech and Al Piyatzmei. The Gemara right away makes the point that the Tanya of the Mishnah says you have to have two Eidim, and there's a Braise that says you don't. So right away the Gemara makes a point. So the Gemara doesn't right away say another thing, that the Mishnah says it's Osir, and we have a Braise, which two opinions that it's not Osir. And bring this Nita Philip Bekesha to the day of Fontana, the Nazos of Akanis. The Gemara brings this Braise later, not even in connection to the Din of the Mishnah, which seems to say that it's Osir to warn her. What does that prove? That this is not a kind of machlekes. If the Braise would be a machlekes, the Gemara would have brought it right away. The Mishnah seems to say Osir. And here we have a braise that's not. The braise that gebracht in Gemara place via Eichocha, Ados was toned by Yishmael Zok. The Gemara brings this braise, the machleik is whether it's a reshus or a cheva. But concerning something else, Gemara wants to prove that what it says in the name of Rabbi Shmuel, that Eino the Mekana Lishter is beruach. That person does not, should not be Mekana his wife, warn his wife, unless a spirit came in. And there is a question in Gemara, what does it mean, a good spirit or a bad spirit? So the Gemara wants to prove, maintes with the daya for the mandoma ruach tare. The Gemara wants to prove that it goes according to the opinion that says it's a good, a toyadik, a pure ruach. The I amret ruach tume, if you're going to say to warn her, is that ruach tume is bad, so how could there be a machlekes about kivin Rabbi Shmuel? The Gemara says, whether you have to or you're allowed to, if it means ruach tume, then obviously you can't do it. You can't say that it's a cheva or even a reshus to bring ruach tume. So the gabavad, the Gemara brings these two opinions, but the Gemara doesn't bring it as a stira, so to speak, to the Mishnah, where the Mishnah says osir, and here we have two opinions that it's not osir. So what does that prove? That the Mishnah is not talking, it's not an argument. What they two say, whether it's Chayv or Shus, is not arguing against the Mishnah. Nor the Mishnah and Braise are even Tzvei Fashid in the following. The Mishnah and Braise, it's a Chiddush of the Rebbe, talking about two separate cases. And they're not arguing. When the Mishnah says it's also, it's a one case. When they say it's a Chayv or a Rishus, it's another case. And not, and they admit that in the case of the Mishnah, that case, as we'll explain, is Takeh Osir. The Mishnah will agree that in the other case, is not Osir. What is it? In Kinoi, when the husband warns his wife, there are two ways to go about it. Two situations. Number one, Akinu was in the gay Isha built it to know. A warning comes to women that's not modest, when is a hagdomah to their stira, and that's an introduction to her hiding. She's a woman that's immoral. She does things which she shouldn't. She goes hiding with people. And that's the warning, is an introduction. Don't hide. If you hide, you'll be in trouble. That's the one way. When will he warn her? When he finds, as the expression of the Yerushalmi, he found immoral behavior in her. And the husband suspects her in doing some adultery, not beira. He said, so he's warning his wife, so he's going to be able to verify if she will not listen to his warning and she will go into hiding, he'll be able to verify whether she's guilty or not guilty, whether she became tomei, which means she's guilty or she's not guilty. So one way a person could be mekana his wife is if he sees some immoral behavior and he's doing it because he's suspecting her and who knows what. The second way is different, the opposite. Akina bin Gayet Aisha Ksheira, to warn a very fine kosher woman. The Rambam says, Askinu Dar Zain Benachas. The Rambam says, when you warn your wife, you have to do it calmly, the derech tare, in the pure way, and a warning in order to guide her, to take away a possible stumbling block. Anybody doesn't care about his wife and his sons and children and his household, and he doesn't constantly warn her and look into their ways, he's a sinner. In other words, you always, in normal circumstances, not because you suspect your wife, normal circumstances, you have to always make sure to warn your wife and warn the family to make sure they go good. But from them is mucha, from that we understand, as cheves akino is nitfarbun mit dem, was the baal is cheshed ish in advar aveira. That the idea of the obligation to warn her is not because he's suspecting her in doing an aveira. Or the gizem by yidvorim churim kiyetzim, or he saw her immoral behavior and therefore he assumes that something wrong there. Nor as he's a prat from the minyan kloli from adrochas ish, it's a detail in the general idea that a person has to train and guide and educate his family, educate his wife. Just like you have to care and educate your children, your whole family. So here too. So she's not a woman that's suspected in doing an aveira. So there's two types of kinui. But the fire in mitzvah chachamim abnei Yisrael lekanes nesheim. That's why it's a mitzvah. The Rambam says it's a mitzvah. The chachamim said it's a mitzvah to warn the wives. Bechlal. Doesn't say to a woman who's suspected. So yadir isha. To all wives, all women. Constantly, you have to do it. You have to always remember, don't do it too much, don't go extreme, not in a laughter way, don't scare her. Don't jump and warn her in front of Adim. You have to be very careful how you do it, but it has nothing to do with suspecting the women. So there are two ways of kinui. Those are the two situations, the difference in the Mishnah and the Braise. In Mishnah, where Zokt HaMekane, Dievet, the Mishnah where it says, if you were Mekane, your wife, etc., etc., B'dievet, that's a Chavad Nakinu, it's Aisha, Shemosh, Abad, Vorim, Chorim, Kiyetze, B'zeh. That's talking about a woman that you found immoral behavior. But this is the introduction to her maybe going into hiding with a man. And in them how the Rambam as Lashita Sababli is also Lakanis could Lakanis. As I'll explain later, the Rambam Taka says, you're not allowed to be Mekane. In such a way, you shouldn't be Mekane. You shouldn't warn her. We'll see later why. Bechura, at first glance, you would think the opposite. If he knows that she's doing bad things, certainly she'll warn her. No, the Rambam will explain. But he says, I'll tell you later. I'm not telling you, but I'm just telling you that the Rambam is talking about that it's a mitzvah. He said mitzvah chachomim, that's not that case. When he says in the Mishnah, also that also the comment says, if you warned her, but means she shouldn't have warned her. It's also the Rambam learns this isn't a case where she behaved immoral. And that's what the Mishnah is talking about. But in the Braisa, when there's an argument with Shmuel and Rabbi Akiva, whether the warning is an obligation or a reshus, that's the second case. A woman that's fine, and you want to just train her, so you say these things in a nice way. That's what they argue, whether it's a mitzvah or you're able to do it. Rabbi Shmuel says, this whole idea of warning, even by an Isha Ksheira, is only a reshus. You don't have to do it, but you could do it if you want to. It's a chidush in the sinas seter. It's a chidush that you could do it. You might think you shouldn't. And the idea is, the Torah allows you to, even a regular kosher woman, that you're able to warn her. Why would we think you shouldn't, that you need a special heter? Because the Torah says, don't hate your brother, in other words, another yid in your heart. So you would think that you can't warn her. That shows like you're having an opposite of Abbas Yisrael to the wife. Taylor says, in this case, Chodj the Kinder can bring it to Tage Vesina, even though if you warn her, could bring to arguments, could bring to hatred, she'll be upset. So Bishmol says, you're allowed to Taylor made it allowed because it's going to be good for the behavior, etc., etc. But Rabbi Akiva, as the Kinder was complete, he says that this warning that comes to a woman just to train her, to educate her, not because she's bad, is an obligation to do. Nazay paskin the Rambam canal. The Rambam paskin like that. We said before the Rambam is talking about such a case. He said before Siv Dalet, the Rambam is talking in a case when he gives all the details that you should do it to train your wife, etc., etc. So he's talking about that case. And there Itaka says it's a mitzvah. So the Rambam paskin, it's a chayva. So the whole obligation, the argument of Shmuel and Akiva is when she's a Ishak Sheiro and you want to just educate her. And in that gufa, the Rambam paskins like Rabbi Akiva, it's a mitzvah, it's a chayva, it's an obligation to do it. But that's not what the Mishnah was talking about. When the Mishnah said it's osir, it's talking about a woman who did dvorim uchorim, did things which are not nice. So the Peil, now the Rebbe said there are two types of kinui, and that's the Mishnah and the Braise. Now the Rebbe adds in brackets, these two types of the way a person is going to warn the wife, whether it's because she did something wrong or because he's training her, educating her, both of them are hinted in the posik. The posik starts off like this. If a person, posik says, if a person will have a spirit of warning and will warn his wife and she is tomei, or he will have this spirit of kino, and he will warn his wife, and she's not tomei. The arichas in kefil aloshin, the posek is very long here. It says double. He said already, the person warns his wife because he doesn't know if she's tomei or not. So it should have said that. But warn person warns his wife if she's tomei. In other words, to see if she's tomei. The posek repeats it. To warn his wife, she's tomei, or he has a ruach to warn his wife and she's not tomei, is meramez. That is a remez. As the sretzich wegen zwei verschiedene sugi noshim. There are two kinds here, two categories of women. First one is bikinas ishta v'initmo. He warns his wife, the pasuk says, and she's tomei, meaning the kinuts and isha was matzav advarim chorim. He's warning his wife that he found not nice things by her, which means he doesn't know for sure that she's guilty 100% of the aveire, but it's something that indicates. As his mer kor of leimer as initmo, the pasuk says, it sounds like it's very close to say it's very possible or probable that she did. That's what the pasuk says. He's warning her because he initmo, very possible she's initmo. And then the pasuk continues, ordered bikina sish to vin leinitmo. He warned her and she wasn't tamei. Der kino itzani shakshere ladricha. That tells you that you can warn your wife when she's not tamei, just to educate her. So this is just to add to the point that we do see in the pasuk two types of kinuya for the wife. Okay. Now the Rebbe is going to explain. We said before that when the Mishnah says that you're not allowed to warn her, only be the Eved. If you did it, then we tell you the halacha is a case where he found by her immoral things. So, farvozel zainan iser lekanes leisha v'smotzav advarim chorin. Why should there be an iser? Why would we say that's when you're not allowed? Because he found bad things by her. Okay, yaitzav there are things like that. L'chura adarav, that should be on the contrary. Nazaf fal darf mezichar mekanes leisha. If you saw things in her, you should definitely warn her. Chochas kem brengeli di tagar, might bring to argument. True, but you got to warn her. K'dei ziuisit neflahabuf nadvar aveira. To make sure that in the future she doesn't do any aveiras. Unkedei tzukedem avarazan tzidos. And since you suspect her, you have to verify to find out if she's sintake. So it makes more sense that here should be more obligation. Why do we say here it's more svara? Why here we learn that it's not allowed? As is like this. According to the Rambam, you could say the reason why you're not allowed to warn. What's the reason not allowed to warn? So Rasha says the reason it's not to warn, the way Rasha learns is because warning your wife, don't go into hiding with this person, brings argument. For sure, she'll be upset and she'll argue. That's the reason you shouldn't. That's also. Rambam doesn't learn. Not like Rasha, because it brings the argument. For a different reason, he says it's also. In this case, where he found immoral things, there's a possibility that the water won't work. The whole idea of making it recite so you'll take it to the Beis Hamikdash, she'll drink the water, and that'll verify if she'll die or not. If you know it, you suspect that she's immoral, then the water might not even work. Kiddul HaKamen. As the Rebbe says, I said, I'm not going to explain. This is what he explains. The din is, the halach is like this. If the husband is clean, if the husband is not guilty of a similar type of aveira, then she's the only one that is guilty, or the one that we suspect. So then, if she's guilty, the water will work, and she will die. If the husband himself is not clean, that means he is also guilty of similar aveira. The water will not work on the wife. If he ever had relations with a woman, even if it wasn't a relative or a married woman, even with a single woman, if he ever did that, the water won't work on her in this case. What does it mean if he's not clean from aveira? So the Rambam says, that he once had a forbidden relation after he was already an adult. Even the oven in aveira of having relation with a single woman. If he did that ever in his life, the water won't work on her. And then, like Maimer Agimora, according to the Gemara, Gemara says like this: if a person is guilty of adultery, his wife is also guilty of adultery. They usually go together. People say if he's involved in a mushal, they say, if he takes certain vegetables, big ones, she'll take small ones, which means, min echadu, that means they're both the same category. They both say the same thing, do the same thing. One is the big ones, one is small ones. Claimer of mashua, say, yasuka. So Rashi said, what it means is, whatever he's involved in, she will also be involved in. Kumtu, it comes out, as when the anhogas isha shleke the body, if it's a woman that's not behaving properly, is do a great sechshash, there's a big suspicion. If she's doing it, like the Gemara says, if she's doing it, he's doing it. So there's a big suspicion that he's doing it too. If he's doing it, the water won't work. That's why that's what the Tana of the Mishnah says. As an azafal, nafal, where you see she's immoral, osur lekanes. Not only might not help. If you suspect the water won't help, you're not allowed to do it. You're not allowed to warn her and have her become a seita. Why? It's adam chash. Suspicion is that probably won't work for his wife anyway. So why is it osir? So it won't work. And if he'll do it, and it won't work, it'll be a big avere. Because one of the things you do to her, you write certain parsha on a scroll, and you erase, and it has Hashem's name, you erase it into the water, and you give her to drink. Imagine erasing Hashem's name, it's a big avere. But the Eibishter said that in order to help Shalom Bayis, I allow my name to be erased. But if you suspect it's not going to work anyway, then you got a big aveira of erasing Hashem's name. Another problem, what's going to come out, they'll say, oh, it's a joke. The whole Seita water doesn't work. And they say it's not even true. Hashem said it doesn't. It's not true what Hashem said. Hashem said it'll work. They won't know that the reason it doesn't work is because it's his fault, because he did the same thing. So it's a big aveda. So that's why the Tana holds that if it's a case where you suspect her, then it's also to the mekane. But that's only if you're doing it on suspicion. So what should he do? So what should he do if he has this suspicion? Not as all your best, and but God is nine. So divorce her. Could divorce her. So you could divorce her. And we don't pass him like Vishama that you're not allowed to divorce. Pass him like Vasilis, so you're allowed to divorce and do that. But the osir. But when the machlek is a Vishmol and Bakiva, whether it's a mitzvah, chayva, or reshus, that's in the case where it's not suspicious. It's only we do it out education of the wife. This will explain why Saita comes after Gittin. Question in the beginning was, why does the Rambam learn a Saita comes after Gittin, not after Nozir? We tried to say it follows the Yerushalmi. The Rebbe said that doesn't answer the question completely. So with that, we were left with that question. Now we'll understand it. Now that we came and we said that the Mishnah, the first Mishnah in Saita, it's talking not by stama a person who's mekane his wife, who's a kosher wife. It's talking about who's mekane warns his wife who's not so good. She's behaving immoral. That's what we said. Aseita achitas, aseita who's sinning, because that's why it's osir. We said it makes sense. Ader pirish in them tamas micha sinozir. So it makes sense that when the Gemara says that the reason why nozir and seita are next to each other, she kol areya seita bekilkula. The Gemara said, because if you see a seita in her kilkul, I don't even know how to say the word in English. Kilkul means her bad things that happening. So normally we learn, what do we mean? That what when you see a seita, the kilkulo, you should stay away from wine, make yourself a nozit, stay away from wine. So Rasha says it means you see how she's dying, you see how disgusting it is. Because if it works on her, you see it. So the kilkul that the Gemara says you see, which should make you get scared and stay away from wine, it shouldn't happen to you, is the disgusting of what, when you see what's happening to her, it says her thigh will fall and her stomach will plots and all these things. The Rambam doesn't learn like that, the Rebbe says. When it says, if you see a Saita, the kilkul is neat kipirish rashe ben nivula bebeishta, not in her embarrassment and her disgust, nor with the pashtes aloshen, the simple loshen. Their kilkul fun aseita achitas. Kilkul means she did an aveira. If you see a Saita who did an aveira, she is mekalkul neiver an aveira. Mekalkul means she's spoiling, she's doing something wrong. So you see her aveira or their einish, sof sabitna. So you see the aveira and you see what the punishment for the aveira is, that your stomach plots and everything else. So according to the Rambam, he says like this, he learns Pashup Shat, that since the Mishnah is talking about a Saita which is a sinner before she even was warned, and that's why the husband is warning her. So you could learn, if you see the kilkul of a Saita, how low a Saita could become, that's what we're talking about. Now, nowadays, Rambam is talking about nowadays. So the whole chet, the word kilkul is a chet, a sin. The whole chet of her nowadays is dos vas yashlok vayish vayish alagedish. You could force them to divorce. There's no seita nowadays. I mean, there's no drinking the water of seita. So nowadays, if you see a woman misbehaving, immoral, so what do? So the only thing is to divorce. That's why Saita comes after Gittin. In the kilkul, which we said before, what's the kilkul? The kilkul is the aveira. So if you learn like Rashi, the kilkul means that you see her, how she died. So you see how she's disgusting and how she gets embarrassed. So there's nothing to do with the get. But according to the Rambam, that means that the kilkul is the fact that you see a woman who sinned. So what should I tell you? Stay away from sin. When we say you see a woman who sinned, what is the result nowadays when you see a woman who sinned? You're not sure she did it, but she's misbehaving. She's immoral. So you have to divorce her. Oh, so nowadays, then so since the Gemara says that what's the connection between Saita and Nozir? If you see the kilkul of the Saita, you should not drink wine. What's the kilkul of the Saita? That you have to give her a get. The kilkul of the Saita is the fact that you did Aveiris. And you have to divorce her. So the Rambam says, that's why, what should it be? It should be Saita, should be next to Get, and then Nozir. So he should be Nozir, Gittin, and Saita. Because Saita and Git and Nozir and Gittin are the same thing. Because nowadays, the Saita is the Get. And what the Gemara says, that the reason Nozir is next to it is because if you see the Kilkul, make yourself a nozir, the kilkel is the aveda of the seiter, which deserves a get. That's why it goes together. And this is the Rebbe was chadish, that this whole seiter, that kinui of the seiter in the Mishnah, not in the Braise, is talking about one that is sinned, which means she is immoral. So the Rebbe says, is eich behesem to say that aksuvim a parsha seiter v'teresh shemiksav. This will fit to the parsha of seiter even the chumash. How does it fit in chumash? Hascholas ha-parsha is, the beginning of the parsha of Saita is like this. Ish kisishta ishtei, a man, if his wife will turn away. Umo'al b'mal, she'll do something against him. B'shochav ish'eishe, she'll be with another man, v'nistar v'nitmo, and she's hiding. And she becomes tomei. That's the beginning. So the first thing the Torah mentions is, if the man sees his wife, that she's turning away, she's mo'al b'mal, and she's another man, and he warns her. Unesh denoch retzich v'gen asofik. Then the Torah first says that there's a suffix overall of ruach kima v'kinyan sishta v'nitmo elay nitmo, that the person will have a spirit, and the spirit will be whether she's tomei or not tomei. So what do we see here? So first he starts off by saying, as if it's a fact, a man sees his wife not behaving. That's the beginning. So that's the beginning of Satan. Just like in the Gemara, in the Mishnah, the Rebbe learned that pshat in the first Mishnah is that she is a chaitas, she's not behaving. And that's what the Mishnah is talking in the beginning. The Pasuk is the same thing. It starts off by a person who sees his wife is not behaving. And then first it says that he doesn't know if she's guilty or not. Even in the second Pasuk, where it says that there's a suffix whether she's guilty or not, the guilt is first mentioned before not guilt. The first part of the pasuk we said before, where it says he doesn't know if she's guilty or not. First, it says guilty. Guilty means that he sees already that there's a strong probability that she's guilty. So we see that in the pasuk also. So this is the way the Rambam learns pshat in the Gemara. Rasha goes according to Zon Shita. Rasha doesn't learn like the Rambam that the first mission is talking if you warned your wife who is immoral, etc., etc. Regular case of kina, echayisha vaser hot nitkin gzamba, you can vorm chorin case. Even a wife that you didn't see anything wrong. Bemele, so Rasha learns, therefore, lenta seite is achan nozir. Seite is after nozir, not after gitten. Balascholat msich the seite hot nitkin shaychas msich the gitten. There's nothing to do with gitten, because we're not talking about a woman that if you don't warn her, you have to divorce her. See, according to the Rambam, that the Mishnah is talking about a woman who's immoral. So that's what seite is. So if you don't do the Saita process, you have to divorce her. So Saita and Gitin go together. But according to Rasha, it's nothing. It's talking about a regular woman that you warn her because you have to train her, you have to educate her. So there's nothing to do with Gitin. So that's why Saita is only with Nozi. And the second thing Rasha learns, Shekola Reya Saita Bikakula, is that Mefarish Benivulu Bebishta. Rasha says when it says if you see a Saita in her kilkul, stay away from wine, kilkul doesn't mean like the Rambam we said, means the her Aveira. Kilkul means look what happened to her. Because there's nothing to do, it's not talking about her, taking to see what her aveda. And the third thing is that Isa Lakanis is well, maybe ultimately the target of Sishali, the evil of Philly Tera. The Rambam says, why what we learned before, why is it osir to the Mekana, your wife? The Rambam says, because if she's doing it, and we're talking about a woman who really probably she's guilty, he's doing it too, so it won't help. So that's why it's osir. Rasha doesn't say that. Rasha says, you know why it's osir? Because you'll make a machlaikis. Because she'll be upset at you, even if she's innocent, and she'll turn out to be innocent. But you'll make a machleka. Why do it? Because Rasha doesn't learn this pshat that the Mishnah is talking about a woman who is probably guilty. That's how it starts. Well, the Rambam learns like that. So according to the Rambam, we had answered all the kashas. The kasha was, why does the Rambam learn say that the Saita is after Gitin? Because the Rambam learns that the Mishnah, that's about Saita is talking, and the beginning of the Pasuk is also talking about a woman who's guilty, and that's why you warn her. And that has to come after Gittin, because the warning is connected to a get. And the second Shaila, how could the Rambam say that it's a chiyuv to warn when in the Mishnah it says it's osir to warn? So the answer is very simple. They're talking about two different things. When the Mishnah says osir, it's talking if it's a woman who is probably guilty. Then it's osir, because probably he's also guilty in the mind, the water won't work. But the Rambam, when he says it's a mitzvah, a regular case, when he says mitzvahs chachomim, to do a case, to train your wife, to educate your wife, and that's fine. Now we said according to the Rambam. It's a big chiddush. It's not made it a pshat that the Mishnah is talking about a woman who is probably guilty. That neich vashtein the shayches from ascholas amasichta to resiim. We'll understand the connection from the beginning of the Gemara and to the end, because usually the beginning of sichta and then go together. What's the end of Gemara seita? Beitisne yirashed ikyanod. The Gemara said that when a certain person passed away, there's no more yirashed, no more people afraid of aveiras. Comes Rav Yosef and said, don't mention the word yirashed, because there is still yirashed. People are still afraid of aveiras. Me, Lamashal, and himself, he said, me. That's the end. So what's the connection? Now the Rebbe said, the mitl to mesayim zayim sichta seita. When we finish mesichta seita, the Rebbe always looks at the, also, it's not just finishing learning. To finish, get rid of mesichta, of a seita. To take away the concept of a seita. That's the end of mesichta seita. As only zayim seita achetas. See, it starts over the seita, a woman who is probably guilty. So when it comes to the end, you say, how do we get rid of this seita? We shouldn't have to follow the laws of Saita. We should remember that there is a concept of Yirashet. And finishes off by saying, don't learn that there's missing Yirashet, because there is me. That means by the time you come to the end, you come after you see what happened, you come to the inyan of Yirashet, then there's no more possibility or probability of a mitzvah of a seita. Because the whole mitzvah of a seita, she's not yirashchet, she's not, she has no yirashamayim. So the Mishnah says, you started off with a yirashchet, a woman who is a chitas. So I'm finishing off that how to get finished with that, rid of that, is if you have yirashchet. So take out that's missing yirashchet, there is yirashchet. So this is according to the way the Rambam learns it. The first Mishnah at the beginning is talking about a seita that's chitaz, that she's probably guilty. What about according to Rashi? Yes, Lebaya, the Shaykhs are not like Lashitas Rashi. Rashi could also explain the beginning and the end, the connection. Rashi learns that when the first Mishnah says about the Seita, is not talking about the chitaz, a woman who's probably guilty, but talking about a regular kosher woman. So therefore, when the Mishnah continues, what you do that you have to, she went to hide, and then you have to give her to drink. Is nit mutgish as a stretchback and seita chitaz. Rashi doesn't say that. It's talking specifically dafke, stressing by a woman who sinned. But afilu yitera, even if she's tired, this process goes on. Rashi says the loshen. Afilu yitera. Rashi says you shouldn't. Rashi explains when it says in the Mishnah, it comes from out from the Mishnah. It's osir to warn. So Rashi says because you'll make an argument even if she's tired. So Rashi makes it clear that the Mishnah is talking about a woman that's tired. So there's still a connection to the beginning. Like Dem Pirish Hayidua, we know there's a famous pshat that Rebbe brings it himself also in different sichas, in Yirashchet. What does it mean, Yirashchet? The Gemara says at the end, don't mention Yirashchet, because there is Yirashchet. What's Yirashchet? Yirashchet, normally it means Yirashamayim. Person's afraid. Sometimes you're afraid of doing an Aveira because you're afraid of the punishment. Yirashchet means I'm hot made and nit fanenish. Not because you're afraid of the punishment. Yirashoenish, fear of the punishment. But the chet bring that the sin will bring. Nor far dem chet gufa, yiras chet means you're afraid of the avere. The etzem zach tzaton epes vizis heipach rotzim Hashem. Yiras chet means you're afraid to do anything which is against the Eivish's will. But that inyan is mutkish b'myuchad by a seita v'seteire. That fits more to a seita that is toyer, that is good. Why? All averes hob manenish. All averes have a punishment. U'bemeilis b'zeyal ha-shayach yireh funum chet aleinu yiras einish. So by all the averes, the shayach is that you're afraid of the avere. And you're afraid of the punishment. Besides, with exception of a woman that's toyer, that's fine, that's innocent, not guilty. And what happened to her? And if she drank and went to hide and drank, is neat nor was ir kumpit kanenish. Not only will she not be punished, she gets great reward. The nix of an izazaret says she will be clean and she will have children. The Chazal say, "Hoy, she let us betzaya, let us berevach." Till now, if she had pain in giving birth, she will give birth easier. The kevis let us zechorim. If she had girls, she's going to have boys. So we see that she, by her, by a tehera, she will not get punished. She can't get a brocha. Full deswegen, still, darf sie bringen a mincha als kapore. She also has to bring a korban mincha to forgive. Why does she have to be forgiven? While the etzem zach was by iris given stira, she's toyer, she's fine. But the fact that she went into hiding, even if it wasn't forbidden, Luvay dem kine abal. It's only forbidden because the husband warned her, but it's not a real forbidden way. Is nitken hanhoge heruya. It's not the proper hanhoge, not the proper behavior. By then, by yiris dos tire. So if she did hide, I feel even she tutes with the cheshmat of them, so they become in the scharf and nisra zara. Even if she does it, sometimes it says in Gemara, a woman who couldn't have children and she was a tzadekis. She went and she went to hiding and had her husband warn her, and then she drank. And we said before that if she drinks and she's toya, she gets a bracha to have children. So she did it. So even if she does that, it's still a problem. She shouldn't have done it. Is asimenas is felt yirashet. It shows that she's missing yirashet. She's missing the chira of the chet itself, because it's not after the punishment. She won't. If she's innocent, she knows she won't be punished. So there's no yiras ha'inish by her. But yirashet is. It's for not a nice thing to do. So she shouldn't have done it. So the beginning, according to Rashi, is talking by a woman who's a good woman, and he warns her. And the end says that you have to have yirashet. That's telling this toyrigus. According to the Rambam, we're telling something to the woman who's guilty. Want to get finished with the guilt, so now on she be yirashet. And the woman who's innocent, but she still went into hiding, to tell her this also is missing yirashet. And the far is the seam with gemar from Masechta Seita. That's what the end of Masechta Seita, which means the end of the concept of Seita, the real thing of not to have any form of Seita, not even a toyrike. When you come to the level of realizing that there should be yirashet, not like the mission says yirashet was bottled, but like he said, I'm here, so there's yirashet. You have to have yirashet, and then the seita will come to an end. And this is say according to Rashi, say according to the Rambam. It's not an easy sikha, but it's very, after you learn the whole thing and you see how everything goes, falls into place, it's mamish, ishmak, to show Rashi and the Rambam, and the Mishnah, and this one, the two ways of seita made it because of.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And,